Hey all, don't forget to subscribe and click that notification button so you don't miss a thing. Also, come follow us on social media at Disney Food Blog. Hey everybody, it's AJ for Disney Food Blog, and today we are going to tackle a question here on DFB Guide that I have purposefully not done a video around because it's a very, very hard question to answer, and the answer changes all the time. And that question is, what are your favorite restaurants? So I get asked this question all the time in interviews and on podcasts and things like that. It's usually the question that interviewers want to know the answer to the most. And my response is always relatively equivocal because, as I like to say, the only consistent thing about Walt Disney World restaurants is that they're inconsistent. They can be great one day and just really not hit the mark at all a week later, a month later, a year later. So even if you had a fabulous experience at a particular restaurant, the elements that went into that fabulous experience would be not just the menu, but also the service, the mood that you were in that day, the mood your kids were in that day, how tired you were, how you felt overall. The experience of the meal can really change how you judge a restaurant. So I like to answer this question by saying, here is my favorite right now, but it could certainly change based on my experiences on my next visit. And that's true. A lot of the restaurants that I'll answer in this video are completely different from the ones I would have said maybe a year ago. But right now, as of this video time, these are my favorite restaurants in Walt Disney World. So hopefully this helps some of you out there who are planning your first trip or planning a trip back and maybe you haven't tried some of these restaurants. I know many of you who watch the channel religiously have heard me talk about these because, of course, they are my favorites and I do recommend them, and I think that they are credible and worthy recommendations for you if you're going to spend big bucks on Disney food, which, of course, all of it costs big bucks these days. So we're going to answer the question for you because I know a lot of you want to know the answer to this question, but understand that this could all change tomorrow or on my next trip or next year. So if you're watching this a year from now, we'll have to maybe update it. And these are in no particular order either. So it's not like the first one I mentioned is my favorite or my least favorite of my favorites. Okay, so first off, I am going to talk about kind of a tie, and this is California Grill and Citrico's. California Grill is over in Contemporary Resort. Citrico's is in Grand Floridian. These both serve the same purpose. These are great restaurants for date night, for anniversaries, for celebratory events. They're high-end signature dining, two credits. They both serve food that is going to be accessible by just about everybody. Even if you have picky eaters at your table, they'll find something to eat. Steaks, pasta, chicken, veggies, things like that. So these are both going to be a high-end experience, probably a longish meal, but I genuinely have decent experiences at these places. You can go check out my full California Grill review where I do say that it is sometimes great and sometimes it's hit and miss, so they're really good on some of the items and not so good on other items, but no experience is either 100% great or 100% bad over there at California Grill. Plus at Cali Grill, you do have that great fireworks view. Citrico's tends to be a little bit more consistent. The food tends to be always pretty good. The service is always pretty good. It is a long meal though, so if you need to get out of there quickly, let your server know that. Next up, I want to talk about Raglan Road, which is over there in Disney Springs. This has long been one of my favorites. The food here is impeccable. They do a great job. It is high-end pub grub, really. It is a one-credit restaurant on the Disney dining plan, so it's not that expensive, but it is a little bit fancier than you would expect for just a pub. But it is an Irish pub, and they have live entertainment. The guys that own this place are Ireland natives, and they actually do still live in Ireland. They have homes in both places, so they live in Florida and in Ireland. And they're always changing up the menu to create interesting and fun dishes. I mean, it's really fun to eat here in terms of the food. So it's not just your typical, you know, Disney tends to have a standard menu at a lot of their restaurants where you have one fish dish, one chicken dish, one steak dish, one pasta dish. Over at Raglan Road, the menu is exciting. It's funny to read. It's just a good experience overall. FYI, if you do go to Raglan Road, especially in the evening when they have the live entertainment, it can be a little bit hard to hear your dining companion. So be prepared for that. Next up, we're gonna head over to Le Cellier. This is a controversial choice on my list because I know a lot of you think it's too expensive and you haven't had good experiences there. Le Cellier, for me, is kind of a throwback. When I first started covering Disney food, Le Cellier was the one place it was impossible to get into in Walt Disney World. Everybody ate there. Disney execs had their meetings there. To me, it's still really, really good. It's become a signature restaurant for both lunch and dinner, so it's very expensive, and it's probably too expensive for what you get. But they do have great steaks. They have some some great side dishes. This is a straight up steakhouse with heavy, heavy eats, heavy lunch and dinner menus with those steaks and the mac and cheese and the poutine and things like that. So it's going to be a heavy meal, which is kind of hard when you're in the middle of a theme park. It is located in Epcot. That is kind of rough, you know, to go and have a big meal at Le Cellier and then sort of like roll yourself out and go back, you know, on Mission Space. But I still love Le Cellier. I always look forward to every opportunity I have to eat there. Next up, Garden Grill, also in Epcot over in Future World. You guys have heard me talk about this a lot. This is one of my favorite character meals for several reasons. First up, good food. I think it's really good food. I've heard a couple of you mention, I'm not going to say complain, you're not complaining, you're mentioning that you've had bad experiences and the food wasn't worth the money as far as you're concerned. My experiences there have been good. I like the food and I like that it's served family style as well, which means they bring the food directly to your table. You don't have to get up and go to a buffet, which is rare with a character meal. A lot of character meals are buffet meals. So here it is a character meal. You get to see Mickey and Pluto and Chip and Dale. The food is brought right to your table, so you don't have to leave your child or bring your child with you up to a buffet. And what's also really cool about this is that it's a rotating restaurant. So there's changing scenery as you rotate around. You get to look at all of the various scenes from Living with the Land downstairs. I always recommend this place. This is one of my favorite table service character meals. Speaking of great table service character meals, we're going to go to Ohana next. Now, Ohana, I think the experience here might be a little bit better than the food quality, but the food quality is still good enough that it lands on my best of list. Ohana for breakfast is a character meal. Again, family style dining, pretty standard food, eggs, potatoes, Mickey waffles, fruit. They do have some great pineapple bread and some great breakfast breads here at breakfast time. But again, you get to see Mickey, you get to see Pluto and Lilo and Stitch, which is super fun, and it's a great setting with that Hawaiian Polynesian feel over at Polynesian Village Resort. There's coconut races for the kids, so they're not just sort of sitting there having to, you know, be bored the whole time. They get to do fun stuff, even when the characters aren't right there at their table. So I find that to be one of my favorite, definitely one of my favorite character meals across property. Dinner at Ohana, as many of you know, is an all-you-care-to-eat family-style meal as well. This is kind of a churrascaria style, where they are loading up several different types of meat. Usually there's going to be steak and shrimp, maybe chicken or turkey, and they're on big skewers, which they roast over a fire. So it's really kind of neat to see, neat to watch. And your server comes over and brings you those skewers of meat along with several other dishes as part of your all-you-care-to-eat meal. The big winner from Ohana is always going to be, for me, dessert. That Bananas Foster bread pudding is just exceptional. One of my trifecta of bread puddings in Walt Disney World, of course. I think Ohana is probably one of the best places to start your vacation when you arrive. I mean, you need some place to eat that night. Ohana is a great place to go and really feel like you're on vacation. You get one of those Lapu Lapus, which is a drink and a pineapple, and you have good family time to start your vacation. Next up, Morimoto Asia. Morimoto is probably my favorite restaurant on property right now. I think they do an exceptional job. This is a Pan-Asian restaurant over in Disney Springs. The chef is Masaharu Morimoto, at least the chef in name. He's not there every night, of course, but this is considered his restaurant, so he's responsible for the quality of it. And he is, of course, an Iron Chef from Food Network. This is a place where I like to say, even if you don't like Asian food, you will still like Morimoto Asia. They have great eats, absolutely delicious food, well done, and the one thing I can fault them for is dessert. They don't do a great job with dessert, which, you know, in Asian cultures, dessert is usually fruit. There's not usually a huge focus on sweets, so that's almost forgivable. But this is Disney World, so I would love if they would step up the dessert options a little bit. They try. There's a huge sundae, there's some cute churros, but nothing over the top. Next up, 50's Primetime Cafe. I love this one purely for the fun factor. I think it's really fun for little kids to go in and see their parents get put in the corner or have to sing I'm a Little Teapot for not eating their vegetables. I think that's really fun and they love that a lot. The food here is okay. It is acceptable, especially if you order the right things. I always recommend Aunt Liz's fried chicken, of course, and the chicken pot pie is okay. The desserts here have a lot to be desired. They used to have some decent desserts, really fun desserts, and that's sort of fallen by the wayside the past few years. But again, the experience here is Disney Imagineering at its best and one of my favorite places to frequent. Next up, Victoria and Albert's, the chef's table. You've heard me talk about this before. Victoria and Albert's is, of course, the fanciest restaurant in Walt Disney World. It is a AAA 5-diamond. It is over in the Grand Floridian Resort. You are going to drop $250-$300 per person when you eat here. So it's got to be, you know, you're celebrating something serious to go to Victoria and Albert's, or it's a bucket list item for you. I do recommend and prefer the chef's table, which is the table in the kitchen. It's not actually that much more expensive, but it's a whole lot more fun to eat there because you get personal attention from the chef. You get to talk to the other chefs in the kitchen and ask them questions and see what they're doing. To me, it's a little less formal and a little more fun to eat there out in the main dining rooms in Victoria and Albert's. It feels a little stuffy to me, but if that's your jam, if you want something that feels incredibly fancy and high-end, definitely choose the main dining rooms there in Victoria and Albert's. Next up, the Boathouse is another one of my brand new favorites. This is over in Disney Springs. Chef Bob Getchell is over here presiding, and he does a fantastic job. He's been a Disney chef for a long time. He is one of the most dedicated chefs I know. It is really his goal to make sure you have the best experience possible. I love that at the Boathouse, the mantra is, if you want anything, just ask. They will do everything they can to make sure it will happen for you. They want to make magic for you over there at the Boathouse. It's a huge restaurant, lots of dining rooms, big menu, but they do a pretty good job executing it. So I think if you go to the Boathouse, you can feel confident you'll have a good meal. It is on the pricey side though, so be prepared for that. Next up, Homecoming, also in Disney Springs. This is Chef Art Smith's restaurant. He is, of course, a Florida native and a celebrity chef. He does a great job with comfort food, Southern comfort food. So we're talking awesome fried chicken, killer cakes and desserts. He's got a focus on moonshine there, so you got a lot of moonshine drinks as well. This place is great. It's casual, it's easy, it's comfortable. The food is excellent. I can highly recommend it if you're looking for a relaxed, but still really high-end quality meal. Next up, Via Napoli. I'm gonna stick this on the list just because, as you know, it's my husband's favorite, but it is over there in Epcot in the Italy Pavilion. They do some great pizzas here. They do some decent pastas. The desserts are nothing to write home about, but they're usually not in many Italian restaurants anyway. In my experience, what do I know, right? But Via Napoli, I think, does a really good job with their pizza. One of my favorites on property. Next up, I'm going to do Boma, Jiko, and Sanaa kind of all together. My preference would probably be Sanaa, and this is over in the Animal Kingdom Lodge. All of these are over in the Animal Kingdom Lodge. If you want excellent food resort, stay at Animal Kingdom Lodge. You won't have to leave. You can just eat there the whole time. But Sanaa is so great because you've got that incredible view of those animals, when it's light outside, that is. And, oh, they're out on the savannah, and you've got a really good varied menu as well. You've got African flavors on this menu and an African focus. There's some Indian options as well. So it may not be the best for picky eaters, super picky eaters, because even the burger and things like that are going to have some of that spice to them. But man, I'll tell you, when you take your 1 or 2 year old to Sanaa and they can just watch those animals outside and mom and dad can get some peace and quiet and just eat their lunch, there is nothing better than that, I'll tell you. But Sanaa does a really good job with service, is great. They do a great job with the menu as well. I'm a big fan of that restaurant. Boma and Jiko over in Jumbo House in Animal Kingdom Lodge. I would say Jiko is probably my preferred restaurant over there. That is the signature restaurant in Animal Kingdom Lodge. They do a fabulous job. Again, another date night restaurant for sure. There are going to be those African, Ethiopian spices going on in that restaurant. You may not find things for picky eaters there as well. Boma is the buffet, and it's sort of fallen a little bit in quality in the past few years. It used to be a diehard recommendation. I haven't been recommending it as much, but I'm going to throw it in here because they do have excellent soups there. They have fun and interesting desserts, and I like breakfast there as well. And finally, Yak and Yeti Restaurant. Sort of a dark horse here, but one of my favorites, and you guys know I go here on my birthday every year that I'm in Disney World. If I'm in Disney for my birthday, I sneak over here and get their firecracker shrimp because I love it. But they also have that excellent mango pie. They have several really good dishes, really high-end quality dishes. I think the service here is excellent as well. I like the drinks. This is a third-party owned restaurant. They're the same people that own Rainforest Cafe, but don't let that stop you. This is actually a really good restaurant over there in Animal Kingdom. So those are my favorite restaurants right now, at this minute. I hope that helps some of you who are planning your trips for later this year or 2019. These tend to be consistent and reliable restaurants, but who knows? Disney changes their chefs, they change their menus, they make updates, the service changes, so you really don't know what you're gonna get, but for now, these tend to be my most reliable and credible restaurants in Walt Disney World. As always, be sure to head over to dfbstore.com, check out our DFB guide. It is huge and incredible. I will totally 100% say that it's incredible. My team works so hard on that book. It's all of our recommendations. It's an excellent guide, and we really do recommend that you pick that up over on dfbstore.com. There's a 100% money back guarantee. If you don't like it, just let us know and we will refund your money immediately. Thank you guys so much for listening and for watching. I do hope this has helped some of you. This is AJ for Disney Food Blog, and we'll see you real soon.